we have seen that at, not we have seen, actually it happens that bones and muscle work together. So sometimes what we see that muscles are working in, you can say, cooperation with the bones. That means they are attached with the bones or they are just involved with the bones in the movement. And sometimes muscles work alone. So what we see is, and you know that, that how muscles actually help in movement, they actually show a contraction and rhythmic contraction and relaxation due to which the muscles actually help in the movement. So we have seen that basically the two kinds of muscles are there in the body. One is voluntary and other is involuntary. Voluntary muscles are those which work according to our will. That means they work when we want. That means they can contract or relax according to our need. That whenever we need that, we can actually use it. And involuntary muscles are those which do not work according to our will. That means this kind of movement is not shown when we want. They are actually working, they are actually a part of, you can say, an autonomic nervous system, because we have a two kind of nervous system. The one which includes the muscles which work accordingly, are according to our will, and the one system is that which contain the muscles which do not work according to our will. So autonomic nervous system, that means it consists of all those nerves, and nerves, you know, that coordinate to muscles. So that means those muscles which do not work according to our will is actually called as involuntary muscles. And you know that the organs which in which they are present, they are termed as visceral organs. So visceral organs are those which contain visceral muscles. Visceral muscles are, the other name for visceral muscles is involuntary muscles, because they don't work according to our will. Like when you eat food, the you know that the esophagus, the food pipe also has a muscle, the stomach also has a muscle. So you are not telling them to contract or relax. They are contracting or relaxing according to their the system inside the body. So that means they do not work according to our will. Like you are respiring. Right, you are respiring, you are breathing, you are taking in air or giving out. So the muscles all involved in the respiratory tract is not working according to your will. So all those organs are called as visceral organs, because they have a muscle which they contract to relax according to themselves, not according to us. Right. But we have many muscles in the body which we can actually move when we want. Like if I want to, when I want to move my hand like this, so this is working according to my will. I want that, so that is why I'm making my muscle contract to relax in that way. So those are called as voluntary organs, because they contain a voluntary muscle which work according to our own will. So we have seen that voluntary muscles actually work in pairs. How voluntary muscles work? They work in pairs. That means there are two kind of muscles involved in the movement. One which is, you can say that when one contract, the other relax. When one relax, the other contract. So they actually work in pairs. So we have two kind of voluntary muscles in pair. That is, one is the flexor. The pair in the muscle I'm talking about, the pair in the voluntary muscle are of two types, that it comprises of flexor muscle and it comprises of extensor muscle. Flexor muscles are those which are used to bend a joint. They actually help in bending a joint, and when they bend a joint, they are making, you can say, the muscles to come closer. So this is what is the flexor muscle. An extensor one is that which is just used to strengthen the joint. It is moving the muscles away from each other. So that means you can say a flexor one is that which is bending a joint, moving the muscles towards each other. And this thing, extensor one, as the name decide, that is the extension. So that means it is actually helping the extending the joint. That means it is moving the muscles away from each other. And we have actually, if we look for the examples, we'll find many. Like if we talk about arms, then biceps are flexors. That means they are used up to bend a joint. That means they are just trying to bring the muscles close to each other. And the triceps, they are extensor, because they are used to strengthen the joint, and they are moving the muscles away from each other. Likewise, in legs, the hamstring and the shin muscles are the flexors. They are bending a joint, making the muscles move toward each other. And thigh and calf muscles are the extensors. They are just moving the muscles. They are used to strengthen the joint and move the muscles away from each other. So that means all the voluntary muscles, they work in pairs. That comprises of the flexor and extensor. That is the one contract and the other relax.